We commence our look at Melbourne Trams today at the top of Bourke Street, with a 48 tram going to North Melbourne, turning right out of Bourke Street, turning into Spring Street. The following tram is a Route 109 to Box Hill, loading at the tram stop. Melbourne's older trams have been relegated to the City Circle, Route 35 service. This is a free tram service running around the city block. Now a Route 112 tram to West Preston crosses over Spring Street. Melbourne's largest trams operate on Route 96, which runs between East Brunswick and St Kilda. Some of the City Circle trams are resplendent in gold and maroon. Tram stops in the city block are designed like miniature railway stations. It's interesting that the newer trams are all low floor and accessible by wheelchairs and buggies. This is the interior of Melbourne's newest and largest tram, the E-Series. We now travel to the other end of Bourke Street. This is right by Southern Cross Station, or Spencer Street it was called once. We see an 86 tram going to the waterfront arriving. The 96 tram also uses this stop, then it turns left into Spencer Street on its way to St Kilda. The tram driver operates the points from inside his cab. There's a small traffic light type device set up on the post showing him which way the points are set. Yarra Trams, who operate the Melbourne system, have had a lot of problem with pedestrians wearing earphones walking out in front of trams, so they had a very effective public relations exercise.
tram weighs as much as 30 rhinos. So look, listen, be alert around trams.
This character riding the skateboard, they've called Spike the Rhino. We have now joined the 96 tram for a journey to St Kilda. I was having a look at this Route 96 on the internet and found that it was ranked as one of the top tram journeys in the world. This service runs down the centre of the streets until it branches off onto the bed of the old St Kilda railway line, which closed in 1987. I discovered a real gem on this line. The old Middle Park railway station has been converted into a charming little cafe. I left the train here and enjoyed a marvellous lunch in a real peaceful environment. Melbourne people just love their dogs. Even in the restaurant here, they've got bowls of water out for the dogs. You can bring your dog, sit outside, and you can have your lunch and feed the dog if you want to. In September 2018, 4 years after I shot this video, I again travelled to Melbourne from my home in Western Australia. I was looking forward to having a lunch in my favourite little cafe, but to my sorrow it was gone, razed to the ground. Another wonderful link to a heritage lost forever.
The next stop is Luna Park. Change here for Route 3A, 16 and 70.
The tram stop is right alongside Luna Park and the Palais Theatre. One of Melbourne's happiest dogs is down here doing a bit of fishing. Come back into the city, and now we're on the City Circle tram.
They're also home to many brush-tailed possums. Within the gardens, you will find the Melbourne Museum. Engage all your senses. There's a big population outside Athens in Thessaloniki, which has significantly shaped the culture of the city. Melbourne's Greek precinct is located around Portsdale Street. Restaurants, cafes, and cake shops. One of the innovations in Melbourne is the Colonial Tram Car Restaurant. A heritage fleet of Melbourne trams have been converted into these restaurant cars. These glossy burgundy restaurants on wheels are the first travelling tram car restaurants in the world and ensure a unique, innovative approach to dining. Diners can take in the city streets of Melbourne while enjoying the seasonal menu.
It's hard for tram drivers to see from a distance which way the points are facing, so the signals are put up on poles close to the points so the driver can tell which way the points are set, so he'll know which way the tram will go.